Welcome to a new UF Pro Series. I'm Rick Crawley with Achilles Heel Tactical, and today we're going to be teaching pistol fundamentals from the ground up. Over the coming episodes, we're going to be teaching the seven fundamentals, building a shooter from the ground up. Furthermore, we'll go over topics such as sight alignment, trigger control, drawing from an outside the waistband holster, reloading, and identifying and clearing malfunctions. So building it from the ground up, starting with stance. Stance needs to be a natural athletic platform. When nobody's gonna stand toe-to-toe in a gunfight with you, just like you're not gonna stand toe-to-toe with somebody that's about to tackle you. You need to be able to absorb and mitigate recoil, absorb and mitigate force. So with that stance, we want our stance to be about shoulder width apart, legs offset or feet offset from each other, and we want to load that front non-dominant side leg. When I say load, we're just loading that front quadricep, bringing the patella or the kneecap towards the toe. By doing this, we're loading the balls of our feet and now isolating the lower from the upper extremity. So, posture. Outside of stance, I incorporate in a subcategory posture. Posture is seen from a center line or seen from the hips up. So the center line with our spine, if you take my ear to the shoulder, to my holster, down to my rear leg, it all needs to be in an aggressive posture towards the target. As I draw and present to this target, I am aggressive in posture, isolated, and with good posture towards the target or objective area. All right, moving into grip. Everyone's heard of the 60-40 bullshit, the percentages on which you're applying pressure to the gun. Now, if you don't think that this is bullshit, look to the left and to the right of you, or ask a range buddy, or ask your wife, or ask somebody next to you to shake your hand at 40%, then shake your other hand at 60%. We as human beings cannot quantify these percentages of pressures, so now we want to strictly focus on ergonomics and where we can take up the most and the most real estate on the frame of this gun. So as I grip this pistol, I want a high tang grip with that dominant side hand. Also, I want to establish immediate strength because the grip I start with is the grip I'm going to finish with. Now, immediate strength, that is not me muscling the gun, but that is relying on leverage on this gun. So by taking up that high tang of the grip and establishing grip pressures, my grip pressure starts with the pinky.
What I want you guys to do is turn and look at the guy to the left and the right of you, and I want you to shake his hand without the pinky, completely no pinky involved. So no pinkies involved. Now the guy with no pinky incorporated into the grip, the guy that's just shaking his hand, you're gonna pull out of that grip. On three, one, two, three, pull right out. So now grip again, wrapping the pinky first. So what I'll do is I'll come in around to you guys. I'm gonna tell you to get away from my grip, all right? So without pinky, so you're wrapped on me and I don't have my pinky on you. I'm squeezing. And you say, I am squeezing as hard as I possibly can, probably.
You're white-knuckling it.
I'm white-knuckling it, now get away. Pretty easy. Now, if I establish my pinky first within my shake, now get away. Different, right? As I come up, the pinky meets the gun first, wraps and rolls, and now I've got a position of dominance wrapped around this gun. Now I can take these two fingers off and keep good pinky pressure and keep this gun running flat because I've negated the room for the grip or the gun to now move. And I have good leverage on the lowest part of the gun.